Hello class, I welcome you all to the session. This session we are going to discuss one problem related to subscription. I have taken exercise problem 18. We are in class 20, okay? So exercise problem 18. So I'm just going to read the problem, try to understand what is given in the problem. Don't look into the solution as of now. Don't look into this solution as of now. Just pay attention to what I'm going to say in this particular column. Okay, so in the year ended 31st March 2019, subscription received by Kings Club Delhi were 4,09,000. So what is the subscription received? Subscription received was 4,09,000, right? Which includes 5,000. Now, for what date you have received this? For 31-3-2019, you have received this amount, right? So, 31-3-2019, you have received this amount, okay? Now, this includes what? 5,000 for the year ended 31 March 2018, and 10,000 and 10,000 year 31 March 2018, and 10,000 for the year ended 31 March 2020. At the end of the year ended 31st March 2019, subscription outstanding for the year ended 31 March 2019 is 15,000. Subscription due but not received at the end of the previous year is 31 March 2018 were 8,000, while subscription received in advance on the same date were 18,000. Now calculate what they are asked. Calculate the amount of subscription to be credited to income and expenditure account for the year ended 31 March 2019. Now we have received this amount, no doubt. But is it the amount relevant for this particular year? That is, what is the year? The year is 2018 to 2019. What do I mean by this? 1 April 2018 to 31 March 2019. This is what I mean. Okay, so this is the sum received, but which includes 5,000 for the year 31 March 2018. Is it including in this year? No, it is related to the previous year. So we need to deduct that amount. So I'm going to deduct. So rupees 5,000 for the year 2017 to 2018. So I am supposed to deduct this. So I am going to deduct 5,000. Am I right? There's no doubt as of now, right? So I'm going to deduct this. Next, 10,000 for the year ended 31 March 2020. Now rupees 10,000 is advance for the year 2019 to 2020. Is it related to this year? Is it related to this? Is okay, this is related to this year? No. So I am going to deduct that also. Okay, next, subscription outstanding for the year ended 31 March 2015. Now what they have told, rupees 15,000 is for the year 2000 and year ending 2019, which means it is related to 18-19, which is outstanding. So whether it is outstanding or not, we are supposed to take this because it is related to this year. Am I right? It is related to this year. So I am going to add 15,000. Next, the subscription due but not received at the end of the previous year, 2018, is 8,000. Now this is relating to 2018, year ending 2018. Rupees 8,000 due for 2017 to 2018. Am I right? 2017 to 2018, it is due. How much is due? 8,000. Is it relevant for this year? No. So I am going to ignore because it is not received in that year. It is related to that year, not to this year. So I am going to ignore. Next, while subscription received in advance on the same date, where 2018. Now subscription received in advance, rupees 18,000 received in advance on 2017 to 2018. Now subscription which is received in advance for the year 2017 to 18 is pertaining to which year? 2018 to 19, the next year, because it is received in advance. So what I am supposed to do, I'm supposed to take this 18,000 into my calculations. So what I am getting, the total will be 409,000 minus 5,000 minus 10,000, add 15,000, add 18,000. So what I am getting is 427,000. So this particular thing, they have created a format here, statement of subscription statement. Okay, this is how you are supposed to present. Okay, statement of subscription for the year ended 2019. Subscription received during the year 2018 to 19 is 409,000. You need to add outstanding for 2018 to 19, which is the current year. So 15,000 you are added. So this 15,000 they have taken. Next is received for 2017-18 previous year, which is this one they have taken, received for the previous year. Then advance received in 17-18. So advance received in 17-18, which is pertaining to 18-19. So this one they have taken. Then advance received for 19-20, the next year, which is not related to this year. So this one they have taken. 8,000 they have ignored because it is not received. It is not received, due but not received at the end of the previous year, 2018 itself. It is not related to the current year, which is for the year ended 2019. So we are ignored. So if we ignore this, we will be getting what? 427,000. 427,000 subscription to be credited to the income and expenditure account. I hope that this part is clear to you. There is no confusion. We'll be doing a couple of problems so that you can be comfortable with this part. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye. Take care.